Are you moving to Serbia in 2021? If yes, then this video will be very helpful, because today we're going to discuss what you need to consider, what you need to think about when moving to Serbia in 2021, like I just did. Because it's 2021, you need to consider one important point, and it's pandemic. So before you move here, check the cases, check the situation, because I don't know how it currently looks like, but right now, as it for February 2021, situation is good here. Daily average, we have like 1,000-1,500 cases, but everything works fine here. Restaurants are open, shops are open, you don't have to wear masks everywhere, only inside in shops, for example. People are just living their life, we're going on with their life. Nothing is crazy here, like in some countries I know, like UK or Germany and Austria. So check the situation, if it's still good, come here. So check the situation, check also entrance requirements and etc. I would not dive deep into this, you can do it yourself, just check it online. But overall, before you come here, you need to think about very big and important thing, which is where do you make money? How you can make a living to be able to live in Serbia? Because it is important, since there are not many jobs in Serbia, or there are not many for foreigners, because there are already people here who wants to work, or there are jobs which are not really well paid. So you have to have some kind of income outside from Serbia. Think where you make money right now, can you keep making this money in Serbia as well, or you want to open the business here in Serbia, which is very welcome. The next point to think is visas. Do you need visa? You don't need visa. Usually if you travel to Serbia for a short period of time, for like more touristic stay, you don't have to have a visa. Most of the countries in this world, especially European Union and Western countries, but also Russia and China and India, but you don't need to have a visa to come here. You can just come with your passport and stay here. For some people it can be 90 days, especially for people from Europe, US again, and some other countries. For some people it's 30 days. Like me, I'm Russian, I have to leave after 30 days. So if you want to stay longer, of course you need to think about your resident permit or your visa. What can you apply for, what you can receive, because there always has to be some reason why you want to have a visa. But there are transit visa, which valid for 6 months. It's kind of like tourist visa, so it will allow you to stay in Serbia for 6 months. But if you want to stay longer, for example 1 year and longer, you need to apply for a temporary resident permit, where you have to explain why you want to apply for this. There are some particular reasons people can apply for resident permit in Serbia. For example, you want to open the business, you want to study here, you of course want to work, you want to do internship, or you want to become self-employed, do research. Any professional activity is a reason to stay in Serbia. But also if you buy real estate, you buy a house, it does not have to be an expensive one. Serbia doesn't require you the minimum price of the real estate, so that means you can buy any real estate with any price tag on it, and you can receive resident permit here. If you're looking to buy real estate here is quite affordable, and as I mentioned, you can receive the resident permit here for that reason, and you can stay almost all your life, or all your life if you want to. Real estate prices range also between cities, between center city, not center city, but overall you are looking for a city center for 2,500 euro per square meter. If you want to stay longer here, if you plan to make Serbia your home for a long time, you can apply for permanent resident permit after 5 years living here. And if you're married and Serbian woman or Serbian man, you can apply after 3 years living here. You can receive resident permit which doesn't have the date, so basically permanent resident permit after you can apply for passport after some years. If you don't want to apply for any visa, you can just stay, for example, 90 days if you are American or you're from Europe, and then leave Serbia, go for example to Albania or somewhere else, and come again after 90 days. When you apply for a resident permit here, you need to provide particular documents depending on the reason why you apply for, but important mentioned that you can show enough money to Serbian government so you can support yourself here, and also that you have health insurance. It will take up to 3 weeks to proceed your resident permit application, and so you will get it in about 3 weeks or 1 month. And basically we will just mark this permit in your passport. It will be just printed there. If you plan to work here, in addition to the resident permit, you need to apply for a permit for work or permit for self-employment if you wanna be self-employed here or open the business. And in fact, there are many companies, organizations who will help you. Just Google on the internet, because there are a lot of agencies who help foreigners to come to Serbia. So we will organize the paperwork for you, because it's in Serbian, so it might be a little bit complicated if you go there alone. You organize all your documents alone, so you better request the help from professionals who speak Serbian, of course. Also, don't expect to get a job here or get it easily, because there are already a lot of people who want to have a job here, where a local company would preferably hire locals, and they have to, because of the law. We have to prove the government that we didn't find the person from Serbia. But if you are some kind of particular professional or you're an English speaker, you can always find a job. But don't expect it to happen immediately, to happen it super easy and fast, and don't rely on this. I would definitely recommend, before you come here, to check Facebook groups, to talk to other foreigners. If you have any questions, if you have any concerns, you can just ask them and somebody will reply. I see every day there are people writing, people also here looking for friends or on activities here in Serbia, but also people who are actually not in Serbia, they are just asking questions. And yeah, it's a good place to inform yourself, to connect with people and maybe even make friends. Some groups I would recommend are expats in Belgrade, also foreigners in Belgrade, expats in Serbia, and that's pretty much it. Also check the website called Moving to Belgrade if you are moving to Belgrade, but overall it has great information made by some organization. We just wanted to make a nice helpful guide for you people who from abroad who want to move to Belgrade. It's called movetobelgrade.com. Also thing to consider, if you are traveling frequently, I would definitely check availability of flights from Belgrade airport, because it's not like in Paris or in Berlin. So you will have limited availability of flights. In some destinations you will need to make a change to get somewhere. Overall, it's well connected with Europe. It also has some low costers like Wizz Air, so you can get for a really small money to many places in Europe. But check in case if you travel somewhere frequently that you want to have this flights available, you want to have affordable price, no hassle. And of course, other important point is the cost of living. Cost of living should be calculated how much money you need in Belgrade. There are a Numbeo website where you can see all prices of everything here. Overall, how much do you need per month? How much do you need in Belgrade? For example, average salary here is 400, 500, 600 euro per month in Belgrade. So you should have definitely more than that to live comfortably. Also check apartments, how much apartments are cost, because cost for apartments are pretty much depending on the location, on how luxury, not luxury it is, of course, but also location is so important in Belgrade. You want to be close to center, because center is the heart of the city where all these nice old buildings, so you want to be not far away from that, but you will have the most expensive prices in the city center and in surrounding areas. One of the cheapest would be Novi Belgrade, which means new Belgrade, so it's a new city, and you probably don't want to live there as a foreigner. At least I would not prefer to, because it's already a different kind of vibe. Overall, you will see prices in the city center for apartment with a one bedroom between 350 and 600 euro per month. Also pay attention that utilities can be expensive in Serbian apartments. So for example, you will pay 300 euro for apartment itself, and your utilities can be up to 150 euro. Calculate, of course, already with utilities, because it can be quite shocking. So you would pay almost half of the price for utilities only. If you have kids, think about kindergarten, school, university, which school they can get to, because Belgrade, for example, has a lot of international schools. You want to check it, of course, also prior to arriving here. You can find a school which you like for your kids, for example, Russian schools, they have them, or English school, Italian school, I don't know. So you have to check it also prior coming here. And overall, I would recommend you to prepare for more relaxed lifestyle. People are not rushing here. That's why I want to aware you, because things here can take a little bit longer to accomplish. People are more relaxed and chilled. They do their work a little bit slowly. Maybe that you get used to somewhere where you're from. Overall, it's quite relaxed. People live here polako. Polako is slowly or slow. People like to live more slowly here. It's more a Mediterranean lifestyle. You will have a lot of cafes, a lot of places to relax, and you will be really, really seducted by a relaxing atmosphere when you're walking through city center. You just want to drink coffee all day long because it's, oh my god. Coffee culture is very, very, very strong here, and you will see a lot of people sitting around, especially in the warm days. And just be prepared to be more relaxed, to spend more time socializing, to be more out, to enjoy, of course, to enjoy. Because this is also why we are living in this planet, to enjoy our life. In some countries, you might have a feeling that you work, 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 and that's all your life. Also, weather in the Balkans, it might be different than your country. Weather here is great. It has hot summers, mild winters, very nice in between. And it's overall very comfortable. It's never cold like in Russia, minus 20, and it's never hot like in India. So it has its nice moments, and sometimes it rains also, but overall it has much more sunshine than countries like Germany or Austria. It's more in the south, of course. You will have more sun here, for my opinion, than in many countries, at least in Europe or in Western countries. Weather, it's nice in Serbia. So guys, I think that's all things I would think about when moving to Serbia and what I recommend to you, because I just moved to Serbia recently, also thought about some of those points, and I would definitely recommend you to visit Serbia before moving here, maybe live here for 1 to 3 months, and after only organize the long resident permit and all etc, because you want to feel the country, you want to try the country, you want to learn, explore, experience. Subscribe to this channel for more videos about Serbia, about moving here, living here, how it, everything goes here. I'm in Belgrade. I would definitely recommend to move to Belgrade or Novi Sad. But if you like more smaller cities and more local life, check out other cities. But I will see you here in Russian Vagabond, in Belgrade and in Serbia. See you next time, guys.